Sekera. Sekera, Yakupov with a blast. Block gets it right back. Here's McDavid. Letestu in tight. Kuznetsov scores! Ben Roy-Pouliot.
There's an example. Bad penalty, good opportunity. You're right back in the game. A nice block, as you've seen from the Flames so many times. Giordano makes a good block against the play of Yakupov. Can't clear it down low. A no-look pass by McDavid. And this is a loose puck that's in play. And the one thing I always find with defense want to go after the body. Forwards go hunting after the puck. And Pouliot comes all the way around the net. He's got a body right in front of him. But he's first on the puck and lifts it with the backhand up and over a sprawling goaltender.
Benoit Pouliot with the goal. He's hot. That is his 99th career goal. Back-to-back games of the goal. And Connor McDavid is going to pick up an assist and extend his point streak to 8 games.
And Bob Hartley here is having a heated discussion. Does he want a challenge? And I'm not sure whether he's going to do. Yes, he is. He's going to challenge whether Ramo was interfered with on the play going to the net. That was a no-look pass by Connor McDavid. The shot came in. And this is a pretty key goal. Letestu's in front. Does he get contact? Maybe initial contact. Can Kari Rommel go across the crease? This is going to be a difficult one.
Challenge to determine if there was goaltender interference.
To me, watching that, it doesn't look like it. It's right on the top of the crease. You could see the referee behind the net pointing, good goal. So the call on the ice is the critical one. They didn't feel it was, and it has to be pretty decisive to show that there was interference there.
There you see the coaching challenge criteria. There's only two things that can be challenged, whether or not there was goaltender interference or whether or not an offside play eventually led to a goal.
This is the complicated thing about this. I like the fact that you have a goal challenge for the coach. I think it's a worthwhile effort. It makes sense. We've seen some calls that should have been called off, called maybe a touch to the head there of Ramo. But in the summer, when they looked at a number of these scenarios, you had five different people look at the same thing, and you've got three thinking it's one way and two the other. I think that's the most difficult. Is that considered enough contact to take a goal off? And there's lots of debate here. Marty Gelina was talking for a minute. The only contact I see right there is the left hand to the forehead of Rommel.
And is it enough?
The official was in great position. Look at right behind the net as he comes in and he's pointing. And these are those moments that it almost would force a goaltender to initiate that contact and flop back and hope that you get a call. Ramo tried to stay with the puck and go across.
And the other point we should make here, as it's still early in the season, fans getting used to this, this is the call made by these guys right here.
Yes.
They're looking at a tablet down there. This is not like a review where they're getting the call made back in the control center in Toronto.
And it was Johnny Bear who's on the headset looking at. He was the one behind the net who made the call, and here's his review of the call.
After reviewing the play, there's contact with the original shooter in the blue. There's no goal.
What a smart play by Bob Hartley. They took their time. Marty Gelina talking with their video coach. I can tell you, Dave, in my days of playing in the Battle of Alberta on both fronts, that would have been a goal.